From the OUTV Broadcast Center in Los Angeles, California, this is Brief News Brief, a brief look at today's trending news topics. Proudly combating the thought police since 2016, here's your host, James Heaney.
I'm James Heaney, and this is Brief News Brief. In Montana today, there's an election, a special election. And I mean, all elections are special, but this one's particularly special in so many ways. It's like a snowflake election. First of all, the seat's vacated because Trump tapped the guy that used to be in the House in this seat and has him as the interior decorator for the country. Okay? I'm sorry, the Department of the Interior. But nonetheless, that's what makes it special on one level. On another level, it makes it special because the Republican candidate, Greg Gianforte, yesterday took what was a surefire win. Montana is a red state. And he took his surefire win and he put it into question when he body slammed a reporter. Yes, a reporter from The Guardian had come up to him and maybe, worst case scenario, had a microphone really close to his face. Now, I don't know, like, even if, like, somebody was doing the whole, like, finger to the eyeball thing, you're still not allowed to body slam somebody. But let's just say that it was an annoyingly close microphone with a question being asked about, like, healthcare. Because he was specifically asking about the CBO reports that had said the new healthcare act would make millions of people lose insurance. That's the preface. So the candidate says, why don't we just talk about that later? And then the Guardian reporter, and I'm like, this is my best impersonation. He's like, well, there's not going to be a lot of time later. He's like, and he body slams this reporter. And then he's like, it's just like you and those all Guardian reporters trying to ask your questions. You're going to get slammed. And tells him to get the hell out. It was pretty crazy. So at the end of that, you're like, wow, I can't believe that Republican did that. He took his win and flushed it down the toilet. Well, not so fast. First of all, 2/3 of Montana votes are mail-in ballots, which had already had to have been mailed before this event struck the news. So 2/3 of the ballots out there in a very red state where Republicans usually win have already cast their votes. So you'd say, well, it'll still be close, but at least 1/3's going to be voting no, because you can't vote for a candidate to body slam somebody, right? Right? Not true. In fact, most people that were interviewed at the election polls, like post-election, said this event did not change their vote at all. Now, do you think that that means it doesn't change their vote at all because they already weren't going to vote for the Republican candidate? No. No, they were still going to vote for him despite it. They're like, you know, sometimes you just got to body slam one of those crazy liberals. I can't believe it. It's insane. So let's just think to ourselves, if we elect this person, which this happened yesterday, so at the time it was reported nobody knew for sure what was happening, but he's been charged with assault. He's going to have to appear in front of court, I believe it's June 7th, on assault charges. If he's convicted, I think that's a felony. I don't think assault is a misdemeanor. I think that's jail time doing assault, body slamming somebody. But nonetheless, he's going to be in court, and it's going to be hard to argue he didn't do it when you hear an audio tape. There's more than one eyewitness. There's the reporter who was body slammed, and then of all kinds of reporters, a Fox reporter that says this is what happened. This candidate, Greg Gianforte, body slammed a reporter from The Guardian. But people don't care. They're going to vote for him anyways. He's going to get voted in. Are the Republicans really going to be able to seat this person that body slams people? And if we do, are we not just saying, you know what? And this is a stretch. Come with me on a journey. I've always said violence doesn't decide who's right and wrong. War doesn't decide who's right and wrong. Only who's stronger and only who lasts longer. But maybe I'm wrong. If we're willing to seat this guy that body slams, we think, well, it's okay to use violence to get your point across, to solve these things. Let's put him in office. And it's kind of like Trump, what he said when he was running for election. He said, I could shoot somebody on the street and I would still get elected. This guy's maybe not shooting people on the street, but he's saying, I can body slam a being and still get elected. I can commit assault. Where does that end? Get ready for your brief news briefing. In an interview yesterday on SiriusXM, Ben Carson likened poverty to a state of mind. Now keep in mind that Ben Carson is the Housing and Urban Development Secretary, and he's tasked with leading the department that handles housing for millions of Americans with low income. Now here I had always heard that home is where the heart is. Turns out being in a home is all in your mind the whole time anyhow. The CBO came out with a report on the House Republicans' health care bill yesterday, and it says that Trump care will kick 24 million people off of health care. In addition, it's going to get one reporter body slammed. CNBC is reporting that 10% of Americans are trading in their cars and plan to use Uber and Lyft instead of buying a new car. Now, let me just disclose this. Part of this is reporting brief news that that's possible. 10% of people trading in cars are only going to be using a car service to get around. But the other reporting is that I don't believe it. I think it's fake news. And I'll tell you why. I toured the United States for about, I don't know, more than a year, not quite 2 years. Okay? And when I was there, I was tracking in places most of America, you can't actually take Uber or Lyft. Now the question is there enough in New York, Chicago, all these big cities to say 10% of people trading in their cars are going to be just driving in ride services? Now, if that's true, that means, because they're saying that this is just next year, the following one will be another 10%. Are you telling me that there's going to be 20% less people driving? That would be a miracle. I don't believe it. I'm waiting to do my own research. Today, the Federal Appeals Court in Richmond, Virginia, refused to reinstate President Trump's revised travel ban, saying that it discriminated on the basis of religion. I don't think that travel ban's ever coming out. It's like Half-Life 3. While walking with NATO leaders during his visit to the alliance's headquarters today, President Donald Trump shoved Dusko Markovic, the Prime Minister of Montenegro. And he was doing this as he was moving to the front of the group of leaders. Now, I'll tell you, I've been at busy bars in Los Angeles where somebody does that. Like, all of a sudden you're, like, trying to get to the bartender, and you're just a dude. You're not even a short, small dude that can slip through, like, and you're almost to the front, and then somebody's just like, puts their hand in, they're like, boom, shakalaka, my turn. You know what makes me want to do? It makes me want to take some of the grandma and body slam them. Let's be honest. Trump shouldn't be stiff-arming people to get to the front. What he wanted to do, at least what it looks like in the video, is he wanted to get on camera. What a sucker for camera. He's an attention brat. I had another word I was going to use, but it's inappropriate. He loves attention. Sure, you have to kiss a lot of frogs to find a prince, but one mouth-breathing moron in Florida Frenched a rattlesnake. When his Putnam County neighbor nabbed the nasty nipper, Ron, whose last name is concealed out of consideration for the cerebrally sluggardly, spunkily shouted, "I'm gonna kiss it on the mouth!" He stooped to smooch the surprised serpent, which summarily struck him on the snout. Ron was choppered in critical condition to a care center and is convalescing. He expressed no explanation for his extravagant endeavor, but his ill-advised intercourse will indubitably intervene intermittently anytime anyone accidentally associates Ron with active acumen. The assaulted asp audaciously absconded. And now it's your time to chime. Last week, we asked, did Donald Trump obstruct justice? And a couple people chimed in. One of them, Chris. Chris says, I'm just summarizing. You've been able to read it down below. You want to get your stuff read below? Be part of the discussion. Chime in. But Chris generally says, you know, if it's not obstruction of justice that he's committed, then we need to change our definition for obstruction of justice because all those activities line up into that. Now, Breeze also commented. Breeze is the guy that wrote that story about the snakes. He commented in and he said, obstructed it, he's taunted it. And such a small comment made me think way longer than you'd expect on just several words put together in a sentence. But what I gathered, I agree with. I think he's saying obstructed justice. No, he's taunted justice. Meaning just trying to stop justice? No, he's starting a fight with justice. But what do you expect in a body slam your opponent kind of world? So I agree with Breeze. Yes, he's attacking justice. Which brings us to the next opportunity for you to chime. You want to chime in? You might have your stuff running here below. I'll promise to keep your name generally. I won't put last names. And but the question is, do you think if you commit assault while campaigning for a seat as a public servant, should you be forced to withdraw your name?